Consider the following question. Here the relation is R, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, and J. These are the functional dependencies which are given. AB determines C, BD determines EF, AD determines GH, A determines I, and H determines J. Now the question is like this: what is the highest normal form the above relation is in, and is it in 2NF? If it is not in 2NF, then convert the relation into 2NF. Okay, so you can see every relational database is by default in 1NF, so we have to check whether the above relation is in 2NF or not. For that purposes, first of all identify what are the candidate keys for this relation. So how do you do the candidate key? Go to the right hand side of each production and see what are the attributes which are not present. Like here, C is present, E is present, F is present, G is present, H is present, I is present, and J is present. There are three attributes which are not present, that is A, B, and D. So first of all, to find the candidate key, let us take ABD closure. Let us take ABD closure. If you took ABD closure, then ABD can identify itself. Now from the first production, AB can determine C. From the second production, BD can determine EF, because BD we can determine EF, and because of AD we can determine GH, because of A we can determine I, and because of H we can determine J. Therefore you can see ABD can determine everything, therefore ABD is a candidate key. So there are no other candidate keys which are possible for this relation. Okay, now to say that relation is in 2NF, we have to check whether it is fully functionally dependent on the candidate key or not, right? So whether the relation is fully functionally dependent on candidate key or not. Okay, so is it fully functionally dependent or not? For that purposes, let us see, is there any part of candidate key which is driving other attributes, right? So you can see from the first production, AB is a part of candidate key which is driving the other attributes, as well as BD is a part of candidate key, right? So you can see AB is a subset of ABD, and BD is a subset of ABD, right? Even AD is also a subset of ABD. AD is also a subset of ABD. Even this A is also a subset of ABD, right? Because all these are the subset of ABDs, hence a part of candidate key can derive other attributes. Okay, so we have to break down this relation to make this relation come into 2NF form. So for breaking down, we have to see what are the attributes which will be there and what will be the number of relations in which we are going to break it down. Okay, so to see the number of relations, let us do one thing. So here they are saying that AB is a subset of ABD. So that means if I take AB closure, then what are the attributes which we can identify just with the help of AB? AB can determine AB. From the first production, AB can determine C, and with the help of A, we can determine I. Okay. Secondly, if we take BD closure, then BD can determine BD itself. With the help of BD, I can determine EF. And is there anything we can identify? No, we cannot determine anything else, right? Third production is AD. So if I take AD closure, then with the help of AD, I can determine AD and G and H. And with the help of H, I can determine J. And with the help of A, I can determine I. So these are the things we can determine from this. So I'm not taking this production right now, because you can clearly see this A is a subset of this. So even if I'm going to, I'll try to do it, then I will not be able to, do the solution properly. So I'm just going to solve AB, BD, and AD. So you'll just get to know why I'm not taking it. So you can see, with the help of AB, I can determine ABCI. With the help of BD, I can determine BDEF. With the help of AD, I can determine ADGHI. Right, that means I can break this relation into these three relations, which is the first relation will be R1, which will be having ABCI. Second relation will be R2, which will be having attributes which are BDEF. The third relation will be R3, which will be having the attributes A, D, G, H, I, and J. These are the attributes which we are going to have. Now further from this relation, you have to see what are the functional dependencies which are applicable on this. So the only functional dependencies which are applicable on this, they are AB determines C and A determines I. They are applicable on this, right? So next, what are the functional dependencies which are applicable on this? It is BD determines EF. BD determines EF. Is there anything else? No. Right, is there, what are the functional dependencies which are applicable on this? They are A determines I, H determines J, right? So there's something else, right, and AD determines GH. So these are the functional dependencies which are applicable on this relation. Now for the first relation, where we have broken down the original relation, this relation 2NF or not? Is it in 2NF or not? Is it in 2NF or not? Is it in 2NF or not? So we have to check that. So for the first relation, what are the candidate keys? You can see the C and I are in the right hand side. So A and B are not included. So if we take AB closure, that means we are going to get A, B, C and I. But a part of this candidate key, that is only A, can determine I. Therefore, there is a partial functional dependency which is occurring in this relation. So if because of this partial functional dependency, we have to break this relation. So we have to see what are the things which will be broken. So if I take A closure from here, then it will be A, I. So we are going to break this relation to two further relations, assuming those relations are R4 and R5. R4 will be containing ABC and R5 will be containing AI. Okay. Right, so you can further identify what are the functional dependencies which are applicable on R4. So on R4 you can see AB determines C is a functional dependency which is applicable, or R5 you can see A determines I is a functional dependency which are applicable and nothing else is applicable. Okay, so next is here there is no partial functional dependency. Next, in the relation R2, BD determines EF. Right, there's only one functional dependency which is applicable on this, and you can clearly see there is no partial functional dependency which is occurring. Okay, now next is R3. So in case of R3, you can see we broken down R3 into this relation. For this relation, first of all, identify what are the candidate keys which are possible. For candidate key, go to the right hand side and see what are the attributes which are not available. A and D are the attributes which are not available. Right, so everything else is available. So if I take AD closure, you can see I'm going to identify A, D, G, H, I, and J. And the part of this that is only A can identify I, therefore we have to break this relation. So if I take A closure, then A closure is A and I. A closure is A and I. And am I getting anything else? No. Okay, so that means I can break this relation into two relations. That means the first relation will be containing R6, which is A, D, G, H, and the second relation will be R7, which will be A and I. Right, so these are two relations, these are the only two relations which are possible. Okay, and is there any other candidate key here? No. So even you can clearly see in the candidate key we are not having H. Right, so this is decomposed into two relations. Now further you can see what are the functional dependencies which are applicable on this. You can see the functional dependencies which are applicable on this one is AD determines GH and H determines J is not applicable. H determines J is not applicable because, okay, J is also here, na? So H determines J is applicable. Further here, A determines I is applicable. Now, is it in 2NF? You can see this relation is in 2NF and this relation is also in 2NF. Now you have to tell which is this complete, because we are going to break this complete relation into the relation R4, which is containing A, B, C, R5, which is containing AI. We are going to break it into R2, which is containing B, D, E and F. Next is R6, which is A, D, G, H and J, and next is R7, which is containing A and I. So these are the breakage of this particular relation. Now tell me whether this decomposition is lossless or not. Lossless or not? Yes, these decompositions are lossless because we broken the relation on the basis of the on the basis of keys only. Whether this decomposition is functional dependency preserving or not, you can clearly see we are only still playing with the original set of functional dependencies. We are not added we have not added any functional dependencies, as well as we have not removed any functional dependency, right? So you can clearly see this is decomposition is FD preserving, right? So in case of 2NF we will always get the decomposition as FD preserving in all the cases. Okay, so this is called as 2NF.